All right, hello there. Welcome back to another Wee Bit Different video. It's been a long time since we really got into 2K ratings and seeing, you know, how the landscape is of the game. And so I thought, you know what, let's look at the top 100 players of 2K and see how things are nowadays and seeing what ratings we like, what ratings we don't like. I know there's a lot of 2K players out there, and I know there's a lot of basketball fans out there who don't play 2K. But if you're a basketball fan and you don't play 2K, I would say just look at these ratings to see, hey, are these accurate? In your opinion, are they accurate? Do you watch enough basketball to make an assessment on a lot of these players? Or do you have a favorite team and you feel like you have enough judgment to make, you know, a decision on whether a player on that team is properly rated? So we're going to look at the top 100. And first player on this list, LeBron James. LeBron James is 98 overall in 2K. And honestly, I, as a Laker fan, love it. I endorse it. I appreciate it because dude is the GOAT. You might have a different opinion. Cool. My eyes, he is the GOAT, the greatest player of all time. No doubt about it. And seeing what he's doing at age 38. Now, am I going to say he's the best player in the world? I might have to give it a Jokic or Giannis. But with that being said, I have zero issues with LeBron as a 98. Luka at 97, tied with Nikola Jokic, Giannis Antetokounmpo, and Joel Embiid. Honestly, I feel like Nikola Jokic is he should be an overall higher than Embiid. Same with Giannis. And honestly, probably same with Luka. I think Embiid should actually be a 96. But with that being said, Embiid's still a beast. Really, so far, no issues. KD in 96. Steph Curry in 96. No issues. All looking pretty accurate. Ja Morant is a 94 next to AD. All right. Giving AD some love, even though he's always hurt. Okay, but we skipped. What did we skip? JT. Yeah, we skipped JT. Okay, so yeah, JT is 95. He's the low 95. So JT is the top eight. Not exactly as good as Steph and KD, but yeah, I mean, honestly, I do agree with everything that we're seeing so far. 2K is on it right now. Shea is a 93 overall now. Okay. Props to 2K for that. Not a lot of people paying up respects to Shea Gilgeous-Alexander, and it kind of annoys me. They don't talk about him enough. Guy's averaging 30 points per game. He is putting OKC in a position for a play-in when nobody even thought they'd be there. So, definitely Shea Gilgeous-Alexander should be a 93. I do like that rating. Zion's a 92. Never plays, but when he does, he's good. It's just like, God, like, are we really going to say Zion's better than Dame Time? Oh, I'm sorry. Zion's on the same level as Dame Time. I would give Dame Time a higher rating. Honestly, I'd probably put Dame Time at a 93. D-Book, 91. Jimmy Buckets, 91. And Donovan Mitchell, 91. I don't know. Devin Booker's been hurt, so I get it. But Devin Booker's better than... I really think Devin Booker's better than Donovan Mitchell when healthy. But Donovan Mitchell's been playing amazing. I don't want to take away from him. Jimmy Butler, a 91. But the thing about Jimmy that is so undervalued is that he's a defender as well. And so I feel like, yeah, you could say they're all the same, but I out of this group of three on a championship, then again, D-Book is just so clutch. God damn. He's just so buckets, man. I don't know. You know what? I'm going to say I'm kind of cool with them all being close to each other. Yeah. Yeah. All right. I will say, though, I don't like that Zion's a better rating than D-Book, Jimmy, and Donovan, considering he never plays. That does bother me. Kawhi Leonard's a 90. Sounds about right. James Harden's a 90. That's good. Kyrie is a 90, and Jaylen Brown is a 90. Yeah. Honestly, 2K, like, I feel like they're really nailing it. You know, every player is getting the respect they deserve. You know, you might argue Kyrie's better than 90 or James Harden is, but I think it's really fair. You know what I mean? Jaylen Brown, a 90. I think that's really, really good. Moving down to out of the 90s, now we're in 21. So Trae Young is at 89, PG is an 89, DeMontis Sabonis is at 89, Tyrese Haliburton is at 89. Can't argue with any of these. Trae Young has had a down season compared to other seasons in terms of shooting. Passing is still hot to ass. PG has been in and out of the lineup. Sabonis has had a stellar season. I'm honestly kind of surprised that he's only an 89. I thought he might have been a 90, but even then, 89 solid. And Tyrese Haliburton, 89. All that looking good. Okay, so look, we are 25 players in, and I gotta say, 2K is getting a thumbs up from me. If you watch my first like rating when the rosters initially dropped, I was really annoyed at 2K's ratings, but this is all good. This is all really good. And now, okay, I see the first name on here that this is not, that's not okay. So we got DeMar DeRozan at 88, which honestly might be too high for DeMar right now. He's playing like an 86. Pascal Siakam's at 88, which is good. Darius Garland is at 87, which is good. Anthony Edwards is definitely better than 87. He's been doing it on both ends of the court, scoring really well, defending really well, shooting really well. He's got to be at least an 88 or an 89. I think Anthony Edwards is definitely being slept on. Anthony Edwards is 100% better than Darius Garland right now. Anthony Edwards is 100% better than Bradley Beal right now. Come on, bro. Anthony Edwards right now is better than DeMar DeRozan. Are you kidding me? Ant deserves to be at least an 88. Put him on the same tier as Bam. Jrue Holiday, 87. Julius Randle, 87. And okay, Julius Randle and Jalen Brunson need some more respect, bro. Julius Randle's an 88 and Jalen Brunson's an 88. Like, they're better than Bradley Beal right now. They are not the same. Jalen Brunson is better than Bradley Beal right now. Julius Randle is better than Bradley Beal right now. That is ridiculous. Julius Randle's better than DeMar DeRozan right now. And so is Jalen Brunson. No way, dude. And that's no disrespect to DeMar. DeMar's a beast. But I think they're just disrespecting Julius and Jalen. So, yeah, I don't like that at all. De'Aaron Fox deserves to be an 88. Jaren Jackson, that's fine. Foul trouble or in and out of the lineup. Now we are moving to outside of the top 35. Evan Mobley, 36 with an 86 overall. CP, 86 overall. Okay, LaMelo Ball is better than Chris Paul. Ain't no fucking way, bro. Ain't no fucking way. LaMelo Ball is the same as Chris Paul. Ain't no way. Like, I'm sorry. Yes, Chris Paul's got a higher IQ. But LaMelo Ball is just a way better playmaker at this point. He's a way better three-point shooter. Way. And I mean way better at rebounding. Like, come on, man. Come on, dude. Come on. That's disrespectful as fuck, man. The way LaMelo Ball forces the defense to have to play way outside of not even just the three-point line, but way more out than any typical player. Come on, bro. LaMelo's biggest flaw is defense, and he's not a good defender, but shit, dude. 86 overall? Come on. That's cap. I don't got a hat on, but that's cap. Zach LaVine, 86. Tyrese Maxey. Okay, you know what? Tyrese Maxey's an 86? That's pretty generous, especially since he's coming off the bench now. I ain't gonna lie, that's pretty generous for Tyrese. Okay, B.I. only an 86? You're telling me Chris Middleton's as good as B.I.? Nah. Cap. I don't have a hat, but that's cap. Cap. B.I. is better than 86. B.I. deserves to be at least 87. Easily. Easily. I get that he was hurt, dude. But you're telling me Tyrese Maxey's as good as Brandon Ingram? Cap. Watch Pelicans games, bro. The B.I. ain't coming off the bench. It doesn't matter who's... I don't care if he's... If you put B.I. on the 76ers, he is not coming off the bench. James Harden, Joel Embiid. And you can talk about, oh, it's because Tyrese Maxey's also point guard and shooting guard like James Harden. I don't give a shit if B.I. was 6'2". The way he's playing, are you kidding me? Nah, B.I. is not an 86 overall. He's better. I'm sorry. He's better than Chris Middleton. He's better than Tyrese Maxey. He's better than Zach LaVine. And Kat has just been out, so I get it. Hard to evaluate Kat. Lauri Markkanen's 86 overall. I mean, considering that it's just like a newfound year for him, I get the hesitancy to put him higher. So for those reasons, I'm kind of cool with the 86. Jalen Green's an 80 fucking five? God damn, that is high. That is ridiculously high. Oh my God. Oh my, no way. Jalen Green's better than Scottie Barnes, Josh Giddey, Paolo Banchero, Tyler Hero, Jamal Murray, Jordan. Oh, bullshit. Bullshit, dude. Jalen Green's better than fucking Jordan Poole? Are you fucking kidding me, 2K? Oh, God damn. What are we doing? What the fuck are we... What are we smoking, 2K? Oh my God. Oh my God. I am fucking dumbfounded by that. Are you kidding me? This guy, when Steph Curry is out, is averaging 27 points per game. With players like Klay on the team who are taking up a lot of shots. Who the fuck is competition for Jalen Green? KPJ? KPJ is willing to let Jalen Green do his thing? Kidding me, man? Holy hell, that is so bad. That is really bad. I am disgusted by that. So Jalen Green's averaging 21 points per game, 41% field goal percentage, 33% from three, 4 rebounds, 3.6 assists. Jesus fuck, man. JP's averaging 20.9, 44 field goal, 33.5 from three, 2.8 in rebounding, 4.5 from assists. But what separates these guys from each other is basketball IQ is on a whole nother different level. Two is Jalen Green has no competition and shoots a million shots. JP is actually getting 27 points per game when Steph Curry's out. And we all know how much shots and attention Steph Curry warrants. That is so gross. Sorry, Jalen Green, you are nowhere near better than Jordan Poole. And that shit isn't even fucking close. Wow, I am disgusted by that. Klay Thompson, 85. That's good. DeJuante is better than Jalen Green, and that ain't even close. CJ McCollum, good, 85. Desmond Bane, 85, good. Robert Williams, 85 is too generous, in my opinion. Like, he's not healthy often enough to be in 85. Like, how? Like, is he scoring? Like, he's a rim protector. That's what he does. But, like, bro, stop with the 85 bullshit. Alperen Sengun, 85. Another good player on the Rockets, but the Rockets still suck ass. Nicholas Claxton, being an 85, I think is too generous. Great shot blocker, but no offensive presence whatsoever. Cade Cunningham, hurt. Fine. Josh Giddey, 84, respectable. Scottie Barnes, 84, respectable. Paolo, 84, respectable. All this is good. Tyler Hero's better than Jalen Green, by the way, and that shit is not even fucking close. I'm still really annoyed about that. Oh my God, what the hell is 2K smoking, bro? 20.6 points per game, 43% from field goal, 36.9, which is just better, more rebounds and more assists. And better defense, by the way. Wow. How the hell is Jalen Green better than Tyler Hero? Tyler Hero's got people like Bam Adebayo and Jimmy Butler taking some shots. What the hell, 2K? Tyler Hero's better than Jalen Green, and it's not close. And again, basketball IQ. Jalen Green takes terrible shots. And Jalen Green's going to be a star, you know, in this league. He's going to be. But right now, that team sucks. And he's not where he needs to be. Disrespectful as hell in my eyes that you think Tyler Hero and Jordan Poole's worse than... Oh, God, that pisses me off. And this is where I get livid with these ratings, bro. That's fucking stupid. Jamal Murray, 84. A little rusty. He's had some games where he's shown out, though. I like it. Jordan Poole needs to be higher. I'm sorry, but that's just stupid as hell. Franz Wagner, 84. Mikal Bridges, 84. Jared Allen's only an 80. You're telling me Robert Williams better than Jared Allen? Wow. Robert Williams is better than Jared Allen. Okay. Van Vliet, 84. Koo is 84. Christian Wood, 84. I don't know if I agree. I don't agree with that. I think that's too high. Vucevic, 84. Oh, man. I'm just iffy about these ratings right now. I don't know. Is Christian Wood really better than DeAndre Ayton? I don't think so. I don't believe that for a second. Let's look at DeAndre Ayton. Let's look at Christian Wood. Let's look at this real quick, guys. This is important. So Christian Wood's averaging 17.8 points, 8.1 rebounds, 1.7 assists. Ayton's averaging 18.8, 10.2, and 2.1. And they're saying Christian Wood's better. I don't know about that one. I call cap, but whatever. I'm not gonna make a big statement for DeAndre Ayton when effort is seemingly a problem for the guy. D'Lo's an 83. Anthony Simons, 83. This is where it gets a lot more like easier to rate, because these are a lot more of the inconsistent players of the league who can pop off night in and night out, but don't really do so. So all these really, Spencer might be able to go higher now that he's on the Nets. So yeah, I mean, all these, I mostly have a problem with the mids, like 84s to 87s and 88s. 2K just has it fucked up, man. Like Bradley Beal better than fucking, oh, sorry. Bradley Beal's not in the same tier as Jalen Brunson, Julius Randle, and Anthony Edwards. LaMelo Ball is way better than Chris Paul. LaMelo Ball is better than Zach LaVine and Tyrese Maxey. B.I. is better than Chris Middleton, Tyrese Maxey, Zach LaVine. Like, bro, fuck off. Jalen Green is nowhere near Jordan Poole or DeJuan St. Murray. Robert Williams, I'm sorry, is just rated too high. Like, Tyler Hero is being disrespected, like, out the ass. It's just, Jared Allen is better than Robert Williams. I'm sorry, he just fucking is. I don't think, like, Christian Wood's not better than DeAndre Ayton. Like, sorry, it's just not true, man. No way. And then we get to here, and it's like, again, all these players are capable of popping off. It's just about consistency at that point. So really from what, 70? Because like Wiggins last year was better than this, but this year he's kind of really dropped off a little bit, quite a bit actually, I should say. Miles Bridges is better than 83, but he ain't playing right now, so I won't speak on that. But hmm, 83 down, I just don't really have too much. I think Malcolm Brogdon is a little too high, if you ask me. Where's Derek White? Okay. Well, I think Derek White's better than Russell Westbrook, but I didn't see Derek White at all. Yeah, I didn't see Derek White at all. Where's Derek White in all this? Man's been popping off, bro. Hold up, we gotta check this out. This is gonna eat at me if I don't. Where is Derek White? Derek White's a 78 overall. You're telling me Westbrook is 3 overall is better than fucking Derek White? This is why sometimes people don't take 2K seriously. What the fuck, man? What the hell? Hold up. As a Laker fan, hold on. Let me check some of this shit out. Damn, Troy Brown's a 72. That's fucking cap. Troy Brown's way better than a 72. We gotta be at least a 76. That's fucking cap. And then Schroeder's been playing better than a 78, but it's I'm not tripping over that. Oh, okay, I'm not gonna lie though. Derek White being a 78 is really, really stupid. Like, I want to know who the hell thought that was a good idea. I want to see Jaden Ivey, 78. Durant's an 80. Okay, not bad. Damn, James Wiseman, how are you a 75 when you haven't done jack shit? You should be lower than that. Check this team out real quick. Josh Green is definitely gonna go up. He's playing better than a 76. I'm not gonna go through every team. I'm just kind of curious as to how some of these are rated right now. Yeah. Damn, Gabe Vincent's only a 74. What the fuck, 2K? Tripping balls. Oh god. Okay, I'm done. I've had enough, dude. 2K's on fucking crack. Oh my god. Okay, well, you guys saw for yourself. If you follow basketball, some of the shit's just outlandish. Even if you don't follow basketball, I'm sure some of this had to be outlandish to you, but comment down below what I missed on if I should have been more explicit about something that you guys really did not like when you saw. Comment if you agree or disagree with what I said. But anyway, appreciate you guys for watching. As always, this is All Even Different. All Even Different. And we out.